We are truly honored to have a very special guest, Professor P. Muthukumar from Mathematics Department. He is expert in complex analysis and operator theory. So the aim of this video is to learn from his experience and insights about mathematics research. So, sir, thank you so much for taking out your valuable time to join us today. So to begin with, I have a few common questions and doubt. To begin with, sir, could you please share your journey from being a student to becoming professor at IIT Kanpur?
Okay. Yeah, so it's in school days, I didn't expect like I'll be a professor at IIT, but and also I do not know like after my class 12 what to do, like let's say for example like I had to go for a whether teacher training or for MBBS or engineering college, so I don't have any idea, and like I do not know, like somebody had just advised me that okay, you apply for some BSc courses. And then I have during the time I do not know what is UG, what is PG, but then I was from such a rural background, and so I have finally joined BA Tamil Literature, and then my teachers from Tamil department, so they just send me to mathematics, and I was a little afraid because when we do BSc mathematics, the exam has to be written in English. Yes. So I was afraid about English, so then I feel it's a little difficult course. Yes. So how to do mathematics there. Yeah. But okay, my UG math teachers, they are like very nice, and they encouraged me a lot. Yeah. And of course, like due to them, I'm here at this place. So, and everywhere, like whether UG or PG, wherever, my teachers and like due to them, I'm here. So,
it was a great journey. So the important one. Sir, what kind of research opportunities and facilities are available at IIT Kanpur? Those students who want to pursue PhD in pure mathematics.
Oh, okay. Of course, so now we have more than 55 faculties, and then we have a very good department. And if somebody, it's also like it depends on their interest. So like a master's students, if specifically if they're interested in pure mathematics, let's say namely analysis, and of course analysis like has a very huge number of divisions, let's say complex analysis, real analysis, topology, numerical analysis, functional analysis, like all those things. But if a student like is interested in some special particular topic, so they can look for the faculty profiles in the department webpage.
Yeah.
And based on that, okay, they can feel okay, so this many people they are working in this area. Yeah. And so that and they can approach them, and of course, we have a large number of people and working in a various number of different research works.
So this is again the important one. If a student wishes to pursue a PhD under your guidance, sir, what quality or preparation do you particularly look into them?
At least what I expect, I guess sincerity. Okay, so whether how much mathematics they know. Yeah. That is okay, that's secondary, but yes. How much effort they want to put. Okay. Yes. And then like keen to understand the subject, like are they ready to put effort and like learn mathematics. Yes. Like very carefully and very deeply, and so of course like
sincerity matters. Again, sir, what common mistakes do you see in students starting research for the first time, and how can they avoid them?
Oh, okay, it's nothing like a common mistake. Yeah. But what I feel that okay, maybe when the new students, like let's say first year students, when they read some results, they assume it. The proof okay, like they seems to be okay, and but they assume okay, whatever it's written in the book, so yes. Therefore they believe that message.
Yes.
But what I believe them, what for each and every line,
yeah,
question yourself.
Yeah, yes.
Okay, so like whether this is line, whether is it correct, okay, or is there any is there any something to understand very deeply. So line by line, one has to read very carefully for the basic steps. Okay, so once they have good understanding in the basics, of course then then you know, for their research, then it will be easier for to do.
Sir, how important is, according to you, how important is attending international conferences or collaborating with foreign researchers for a young mathematician growth?
Okay, not only international, whether it's international or national, attending conferences is always a is a good thing to do. Main reason, we'll see like some similar, like, suppose if you're working in some research topic, we'll meet like many people working in a similar areas.
Yes.
So at least then we could know, okay, what kind of, during the conferences, if you attend the talks, then we'll see, you know, we'll come to know that what kind of works they are doing, and is it interesting to us. So since also like we are meeting personally, so we can, after the you know, after the talk, like we can, you know, talk to them personally, and then and inform our business, okay, we want to continue, like do some work with you. So the conferences make such a things. So
thank you, sir. The next question is, sir, what should a student do if they feel they are losing confidence in math despite working hard?
Okay, math, okay, many people like, you know, have a feeling that math is a difficult subject. No, at least, no, it's until one you understand the sum or how to do that, once you understand the method, until then they feel it's very difficult. But after you understand that particular method or other things, then it will be easier for you, isn't it? Like, you know, so the more difficult thing, like students feel that, okay, like, you know, math is a very difficult subject, until they understand. But once they understand, they feel, okay, this is very easy. And just nothing to do. For all other subjects, so they have to memorize and many things. But here, you know, at least if you just understand the logic, and then things will go. Okay. Just only better understanding, that is a. So if you just, you know, instead of hard working like or you know, whatever, instead of just putting like a lot of time on just for honestly reading, just try to understand line by line. And once if they understand basic concept neatly and like thoroughly, and that will help. That will help. So that will kill their fear. Yes.
Sir, if a master student plans to pursue a PhD, what should they focus on during their master's year to prepare effectively?
Okay. Many people, even also for the interviews also, what we ask, in which area you want to work.
Yeah.
And then for many people, they do not know which area to tell.
Yeah.
Of course, you know, people should say that, okay, oh, what to say. But very few people, by looking at their faculty profiles and this and that, so they will say that, okay, I am interested in this particular topic.
Mm-hmm.
But many people do not have idea.
Mm-hmm.
So then better, what's my suggestion is, you know, during their masters, whatever the, you know, from the semester one, like the first day of semester one, understand the classes very carefully. Whatever teachers in the class, the same day evening, you prepare and like and try to understand everything. And if you miss to understand something, you ask the teachers. Okay, like, you know, I don't understand this. Like, can you help me? Like, I remember my MSc days. I don't know how to ask my doubts in English. You know, then I, you know, but I want to learn. So then what I ask, just, you know, what I do, I just simply open my notebook and just like, you know, just figure out my, you know, doubts in the notebook.
Yeah.
Teacher asks, okay, yes, what do you want from here? I do not know, like, you know, how do, I don't know, understand. I don't know how to explain my question in English. So then even now I don't speak good English, but those days I feel very difficult.
Yeah. Even so, I am also learning English.
So just simply I just saw that, okay, just saw the my notebook, and just I'll just keep the finger that like that. So and then he just understand my questions, and then he'll give answers. So
sir, what keeps you motivated during long challenging research problems, and what advice would you give to the student to stay motivated in tough times?
Okay, so nothing is permanent, isn't it? Like, you know, if you feel something is difficult or something we did not get, of course, you know, that may happen for many researchers, like particularly like doing a PhD. Like at least for other courses, what we know, like whatever the existing literature that they are studying. But whereas in a PhD, whatever not available, they are going to find out. So, once if we just, it's not like, you know, like a kind of fast food, like, you know, we can get immediately, okay, if you just think some question, tomorrow we will get answer, no, nothing like that. So when they tried a lot and then if they didn't find, so then better, okay, don't worry, then the time will solve your problems. Maybe like, you know, if you keep on trying for many, you know, many months and if you could not solve a problem and try to change for some different problem and try to solve it. Okay, and my case, I just remember that, you know, I have tried for some problem and then I thought, okay, after that I could not do anything. Then after 2 years, if I look back at the same problem, oh yes, I can do something more. So, you know, so it's not that, okay, you know, within this time, like, you have to finish this question. So it does not, like, it's nothing like that. Okay, mm-hmm. You start problem and if you're not able to do that, leave it and take a next problem, like or the other problem which is like similar to your interest, mm-hmm. and try to solve it. Okay, so but when you keep on trying, you will definitely get some ideas. Okay, so and then, like, you know, after some time you can come back to your original problems and try to solve it.
Mm-hmm. Sir, one last question. People would love to hear your thoughts on, for a student preparing for GATE and CSI unit examination, what books or content would you recommend them to follow the best preparation?
Okay. Books. My suggestion is, like, don't follow any books. So it's nothing like, you know, many coaching centers, like, they just say that, okay, these are the CSI notes, these are NBHM notes, like, GATE, no, GATE papers. No. But then, in that, I feel like at least, okay, maybe for some students, like, for solving problems, it may give idea, but for students, like, constantly, like, you know, like studying from only that will not help them. Okay, so when we make a questions, what we, like, you know, we, of course, within a syllabus, how much they understand the content, that's what we want to check. So in that case, student just, you know, take their whatever they know, their BSc notebooks or MSc notebooks, whatever the book they have learned, okay, just take the book and read them carefully and try to understand the subjects and solving previous question papers. So when they're trying to solve previous question papers, okay, so then they need many more new techniques or new results. Mm-hmm. So in the time they can refer for some standard books, say for example, you know, for a real analysis, Walter Rodin, Apostel, or for algebra, Galien, Damit Futi, and topology, Munkers. So like, for each subject, now they can look for some standard textbook to understand, to know more results on that particular topic. By knowing the more results and try to solve the questions. So how much they're trying with the solving the problems of previous year question papers, that will help. Okay, and also what only thing is understand the problem. Okay, and many times maybe like a very trivial question, but somehow we want to make the question becomes like a looks complicated. Okay, the question may looks complicated, but you know, the content, like, if you just think a minute, like, carefully, and the question is just nothing, like, it will be easy to solve. Okay, so students can.
So thank you so much for joining us.
Yes,
here.
Of course,
it was great talking to you.
Okay, thank you.